Tennessee. Lord, I believe Memphis dress down in Louisiana. Although I am black and brass, the problem's not me pessimistic, brothers and sisters, keep asking. Why does it have to be so damn tough? I don't know where I can trust to let these guns out of my scuffles. My grandma bad, my brother's gun. I never at once felt so helpless. I know you're supposed to be the steering wheel, not just my spare tire. But Lord, I ask you to be my guide, what's the truth? Some strange they had to be. He guided me to Tennessee. Take me to another place. Take me to another land. Make me look at all over the place. Let me understand your plan. What's up, people? Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whenever you're watching this video. So the title of this video is, So I'm a Fuckboy. Some of y'all team Chris saw this post that I made about me and some chick going at it about a post that one of my homeboys made. He shared the link on his page, and excuse me, it was about a woman having 9 kids by 9 different baby daddies. When I saw this, you know, I thought that was crazy, but not impossible. That's the way with a lot of people having kids nowadays, you know what I mean? This shit just don't surprise me or whatever. So I made a comment on this post that he did, and the comment was like, you know, 9 children with 9 different baby daddies, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I hope this is a joke. I said I hope this is a joke, because I got a mouthful to say. I never like that. A female before me on this man's page, he already made a comment. And the exact comment was, hold on. Let me put it up on my phone and I can tell what the exact comment was. Because I screenshot everything they were saying. All right. I'm not gonna say her name, because she see this, you know who I'm talking to. So she says this is fake. She had multiple sets of twins and a set of triplets. That's what she said. I come back and I asked her a simple question. The simple question was, does that make it any better? Simple question. Let me see what she says after that. Oh, y'all, let me pause this. Alright, I'm back, y'all. Sorry about that. You know, I had to go back and search all this stuff because I screenshot it, but unfortunately, it's taking up some time trying to find all this shit, trying to find my screenshot. So I just said, fuck it, I'm going to go to the actual shit where it happened at. So anyway, like she said again, she said this is fake. She had multiple sets of twins and had a set of triplets. I come back and say, does that make it any better? Simple question. She come back with attitude already.
First of all, see comments below. Secondly, we don't know how many daddies she's had. Lastly, those kids look well taken care of. So what business of it is yours? Okay. I get it. Alright. So I left it alone. So this chick comes back to my original post when I said 9 children with 9 different baby daddies. Are you fucking serious? I hope this is a joke, because I got a mouthful to say about this. I said I hope this is a joke. So meaning I don't have actual confirmation about this link. I'm just going by what this man posted. Alright? I don't have no facts. This chick took it upon herself to come on my original post. She said this. If it were true, they're not your kids. 2, don't holler that shit about your tax dollars, because less than 1% of it goes to the entire welfare program. 3, them ain't your fucking kids. 4, it's always some fuck nigga trying to slut shame a chick with multiple kids. Don't be that nigga. 5, them ain't your kids. She said it again, them ain't your kids. 6, everything you read on the internet ain't true, especially when it comes from sites like TMZ and hip hop. I get it. She's right. A lot of stuff on the internet probably not true. Now watch how I come back at her. Now you see she in there saying, it always gotta be some fuck nigga. But say don't be that nigga. Well, by your logic there, you pretty much just call me that. Because if I made the comment, then you pretty much calling me a fuck nigga. From my understanding, but then again, somebody correct me if I'm wrong. But then you try to turn around and say don't be that nigga. How can I not be that nigga when you just sit up there just pretty much call me that? And then furthermore, I didn't make no comment. I just said I even told this chick, or even said in the original comment, before I even responded to her on her comment, that I hope this is a joke because I got a mouthful to say. But I ain't even said the mouthful. I just said I hope this is a joke. Black women. So, alright. So. I comes back at her. Let me find my comeback. All right. So here's my comeback. I said, hold up, miss, I'm not gonna say her name. First of all, let me take a page out your book. You just said to me in your other comment, what business is it of mine? Okay, then by this logic you just used, then I can ask you the same. What business is it of yours or how I feel about the situation? Next, to pull another page out of your book, read the comment, Miss Blank, I'm not going to say your name. Did I or did I not say, I hope this is fake? Meaning I'm holding off until I got the facts. But I just asked you personally, did they make it any better? Simple question. Your response was, look at the comment. So again, using your words against you. So I'm saying the same to you. Look at my comment. Next, I got another simple question for you. And I bet you don't have a logic answer. But let's try it. Why is it when a black man doesn't agree with a black woman, or he says something y'all don't like, he a fuck nigga? Tell me that, Miss Blank, I'm not gonna say her name. I wasn't addressing anything to or about you, but I'm a fuck nigga. Oh, excuse me, let me use your words. It's always some fuck nigga. To me, it sounds like a pretty much you're saying the same thing. I'm a fuck nigga. So, all right. So, by this logic, what you're saying is it's okay for you to make a point, but if I make one you don't agree with, then I'm wrong, right? Next. Another page out of her book. She says, they ain't my kids. And she's right about that. They not my kids. Well, hold up. Hold up. Well, from the sound of it, they're not yours either. So how can you use that towards me when these not your kids either? But let's continue. Her statement made no sense to me when she said that. So check it out. I concluded my statement saying, now I said all this, I have used anything derogatory towards you. So show me the same respect and miss with that fuckboy shit. Alright? Now, this how this chick responded to me after I said all that. My nigga. Let you know she a hood chick. My nigga. You wrote a book report. I ain't reading all that. Well, after that first line, should I go even further? Should I even continue? But I'm going to continue, though. I ain't reading all that. But apparently you took offense to being asked to not be a fuck nigga. Not being actually called one. Typical fuck nigga shit. Y'all see how she kind of slick putting in that fuck nigga shit up in there? To me, she slick calling me a fuck nigga. But then trying to cover it up. You feel me? I may not be able to read in between every line, but I can catch some lines. So, she says, now I'm drawing interference that you're possibly a fuck nigga. They go that term again. I could be wrong. But probably, she supposed to say probably, but she said probably not. Good night. Now, mind y'all, this was 4 something in the morning, Central Time. So I come back and say to her, and apparently you took offense to my original comment. So call a spade a spade. How you gonna sit up there and say I got offended by something you said when whatever I said made you so much offended that you said all that shit you said to me? Y'all see what I'm talking about? Black women. And when I say black women, y'all, I shouldn't have to say this, but let me say this to y'all. I'm not saying all. I shouldn't have to say that because if this doesn't fit your category, then you know it's not all. But I'm going to say that to ease your mind. It's not all. So I said that to her. See, sent me this ignorant ass picture right here. That chick right there. To me, you know, females do that shit. They have no logic. I, my man Sean come back and he saw all this. So he was like, oh my God. He came back like, you know, what happened? Now, here's what's my response to him. I said, bro, all I can say is just look at everything that was said. And you make your own judgment what happened. One comment led to all that. Logic, explanation, right? How about this chick come by 4 hours later and say to this man right here, your man's is possibly a fuck nigga. They go that fuck nigga again. That's what happened. And you know Blank hates fuck shit. So me making a comment about a post that he made, in which I really ain't even made the damn comment yet. I just said, I hope it's a joke. I got a mouthful to say. I ain't say shit yet. So I'm a fuck boy just by saying that. And you saying you hate fuck shit. So what I said was fuck boy shit to you. But what you saying back to me, you don't think that's fuckery? Again, typical black woman, right? Us men, we always wrong. But the black women, always right. Always right. So, I guess we as black men gotta be like this to a black woman. Yes, black woman. Yes, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'm a super simp, ma'am. I'm a super simp. I would never disagree with the black woman. You black woman are queens. You black woman are gods. Yes, yes, ma'am. If I say something against you, ma'am, I'm a fuck boy. Everything you say is right, ma'am. Everything you say is right. Man, look. Give me a break. Give me a break. This shit been going on far too long. Going on far too long. And I just don't get it. I just don't get it. I really don't. You cannot have an opinion as a black man, it appears, to not nail down there, nail black woman, without getting ridiculed for what you say. And like I told y'all, out of all that, y'all didn't hear me call this woman out her name not one time, but she used that term fuck nigga I don't know how many times, and everything she said, she had fuck nigga up in it. But I'm a fuck boy. She hate fuck shit. But she don't see what she doing, what's fuckery. Because it's okay for her to do it. But as soon as I have a comment, you know, it's a problem, right? You feel me? So, now she said using shame tactics on a female with multiple kids. Well, in actuality, to be logical about that, she don't about to have to use shame tactics. I mean, she should already be ashamed of herself. Just think about it. You sit up here and fuck 9 niggas. Not only did you fuck 9 niggas, you fucked 9 niggas without a rubber. You let 9 niggas nut up in you. And you got pregnant by 9 niggas. So the story would say. But you say, we men are using shaming tactics? I mean, we really don't have to. She ought to be ashamed of herself. Because to me, that look like, you know what I'm saying, every time she get touched, she getting pregnant. But I guess she sees nothing wrong with that. This chick who just said all that to me, going back and forth back there, she sees nothing wrong with that. So apparently, in her mind, it's okay for a woman to fuck every nigga without a condom and come to get pregnant, in her mind. And ain't nobody supposed to say nothing about it. Make that make sense to me. Regardless of whether she agree with it, what if I don't agree with it, or whatever the case may be, or even that lady who was in that picture agreed with it. You know, it is what it is. Because if a man is walking around with 9 damn kids, y'all talk shit about that man. Real talk. You would talk shit about that man. But it's okay for y'all to do it. Either the man is doing a job, take care of his kids, you know, you still talk shit about that man. But a man ain't allowed to say nothing about a woman. It's shaming tactics. You said about a woman. And I'm going to stress that, you know, it ain't no shaming tactics. She ought to be ashamed of herself. If this story is true. Which I got a feeling the story is true, because, you know, I just got a feeling it is true. How would TMZ get a hold of something like that? Really? How would they get a hold of something like that? You know, and they say this chick will be looking for a husband with 9 kids. I'm like this, you know, hey, am I saying it's impossible for her to get somebody because she got 9 kids? No, I'm not saying that at all. You know what I mean? She may find somebody, know what I'm saying, that is gonna kick, be down with her. Know what I'm saying? Love her, marry her, and all that. And if she do, hey, you know, salute to her. Salute to her. But I think it's a scandal, it's a shame, though. 9 kids, 9 different daddies. So you saw that the first man wasn't doing shit with it. They wanted nothing to do with the kid. You went ahead of the second one. Now you saw the second one, they had nothing to do with the child. Now you got a third one. You see, the third one, I ain't got nothing to do with the child. And it's a constant, constant, constant cycle. It's a constant cycle. And she said, them kids look well taken care of. Well, that's on the picture, dear. You don't know how they look in person. Remember what you said. You and I don't know her. So you going by the pictures then. How would you know? But now, if I was looking at her picture now, because of the chick, I ain't bad looking chick. I'm posting on Team Chris page. She's not a bad looking chick. But if I was to say, I don't give a damn how many kids she got. She fine as hell. She got a fat ass. I'll date her. You wouldn't have said none of this shit. Or if I would have said, shit, I'll take her in. You know what I'm saying? I'll make her my wife. You wouldn't have said none of this shit. But just because I said something that you personally did not like, you instantly went on attack mode and started calling me a fuckboy. Wow. Wow. And I'm going to leave it at this. Even if this was my sister, who just turned 21 last month, if this were her walking around with 9 kids like that, I would say the same thing to her. You know, it's a damn shame. You sit up here fucking 9 niggas. You fuck 9 niggas without a condom. And you let all 9 of them let go up in you. And now you got 9 kids walking around. What kind of example are you setting? I tell the same thing. I won't show no remorse to her, I tell the same thing. It's stupid. That's stupid. But then, because on top of that, you know what I'm saying, you playing the risk of catching something. I mean, you know, why you just sitting up there just letting niggas just kind of go on you raw dog and nothing up in you? Or at least for that fact of the matter, you know, take them on after pill. It's crazy. It's crazy. So, I say the same thing to my sister. I hope my sister, well, I hope my sister ain't doing that. I mean, I don't know what she's doing. You know, she's in Nashville. I'm down here in Memphis, so I don't know what she's doing. But I'm almost sure she's not sitting there fucking 9 niggas without a condom. But this chick, for what the story says, she did. But I'm fuckboy for bringing this up. You black women killed me. Y'all do. But other than that, though, share your thoughts on this video. I'm going to be doing a show about this later on. And hopefully I can get some black women on the panel who can tell me what does this term fuckboy actually means. You know, is there such word as a fuckboy? And if it is, then why do y'all use that to attack us or call us gay and shit when, you know, we don't agree with y'all? Why do y'all do that? Somebody explain to me. Maybe it's something that I'm missing. Till then, I'm out.